हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम एवरीवन टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. व्हाट वी हैव सेकंड मेन पेपर इंट्रोडक्शन और अमेरिकन लिटरेचर एंड पोस्ट कॉलोनियल लिटरेचर. सो फार वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग यूरोपियन क्लासिक्स. Now we switch over to American and post-colonial literature. Some areas we plan to discuss. And I hope that you have a textbook with you before entering separate pieces of poetry, fiction, drama like that. Before that, we should get a clear picture of what must we call introduction on American literature. You know, American literature has been developed only by the colonial system. That you have studied England history, some group of people from England settled in America after making the colony. And basically there were some people called Red Indians there earlier. But they were totally illiterate and they were living in the forest and some hunting areas. But the people who migrated from England to America were all totally educated and they developed a different culture that has everything been done in almost the initial stage of the 17th century. So this 17th century made or later part of 17 and initial part of the starting part of 18th century, there developed a particular culture in America. And what we find in the part of the literature also, there has been a very big development. So those books written in English by the people of America is called English literature in USA. So American literature or USA English literature, it can be considered different from British literature. But everybody thought American literature was a second category to British literature. But the scene is now different. The people who are educated in America, those people who are very acclaimed writers and poets, have changed American literature into different world. Now the best literature, some people say American literature is considered to be the best English language literature ever written in the world. So America became a series of what you call different colonies controlled by our British people. So it has a strong relation to British culture or UK culture. Then it has become a major literature within a short time. Not only the playwrights, but poets and dramatists and so many fiction writers have changed American literature into a different world. Because the people who came from Great Britain to America had a self-confidence. That you have to keep in mind. Whatever the achievement people tried to have, they should possess at the initial stage, they should possess self-confidence. It is seen among the people of America when the colonies were totally upheld by British people. And so many races that we find in America, different races. Red Indians were totally servants under colonies. And they have been doing a servitude to the people. And the fusion of many races. So the system they have developed, what is called, they have put self-confidence, all right, and they have fusion of races, fusion of different races, developed literature in America because they are confident, only because they know language, only because they are coming from Great Britain. During this 17th century and part of 18th century, UK, or what you call Great Britain, was considered to be a sunsetless country. What does it mean, sunsetless country? Because Great Britain had so many colonies all over the world, or across all the world. So they have been considered powerful nation, at the same time sunsetless country. When the one part of the earth sun rises, at the same time their controlled country now will be having a sunsetting time. So people consider, so they have a great type of confidence to go all over the world by the geographical discoveries. During the time of 16th century, geographical discoveries, all right, paved the correct way to visit so many unknown lands. That may be the reason America was discovered by these people like Columbus. All right, so geographical discoveries followed by what is called Renaissance. During the time of early part of 16th century, there has been a renaissance, what is called, everywhere. They believe what they see only because they have great erudition. They have great erudition, means scholarship. Learning has been one of the major achievement. People began to learn different classical languages, and scientific developments happened. Then almost after that time, so first one was geographical, all right, discoveries. Then you got renaissance, all right. Then you get the last one, what you call reformation. So these three factors would happen in the world, changed all the, what do you call, views and visions of the people. First, geographical discoveries encouraged people to wander all over the world. That may be the reason Columbus indeed, and after geographical discoveries reached America, and followed by, there was an upliftment of information knowledge, what is called Renaissance, and later we witness a reformation period, what is called conversion of people into Christianity and different religions as such. So, what we call these three factors, GRR, what is called geographical discoveries, renaissance and reformation, paved the way for very big literature. And even these people who migrated from England to America, they became the masters of Red Indians, and they developed a different culture. And in Red Indians, that you know, those people do not have education. They had been living in the forest with the hunting experiences, and they have no particular culture. And it is reported by so many critics, Red Indians followed no literature because their literature was limited to their oral communication. Only oral communications had been developed for Red Indians. And in American literature, only developed by 18th and 19th century, witnessed the gradual slow development. And now it has become very best literature. So it is colonial literature Because it was a colony by Great Britain. So English writers, a good number of political and religious writing happened in America after the colonization. Now the writers like Samuel, one important writer, Samuel, write, you write, you have to copy down Samuel Adams. All right, Samuel Adams, all right, a great writer. Then Benjamin Franklin, second writer, Benjamin, all right, Benjamin Franklin, all right, Benjamin Franklin, all right, Thomas Paine, three, all right, notable writers, Thomas Paine, all right, these three writers influenced the people of America by their views, by their methods of writings. Even educated people in America who had been migrated from Great Britain had been influenced by these three people, and they really began to understand or enjoy the field of literature. Late part of 18th centuries, then some other writers happened there. Already late part of the 18th century. Right part of the 18th century. All right, 18th century. At the beginning of 18th century or the middle part of the 18th century, we get some important eminent writers. Washington Irving. All right, one. All right, Washington, all right, Irving, all right, very famous writer, all right. Then James Fenimore, James Fenimore, all right, Fenimore. All these names you have to remember. And yet another very acclaimed writer, Edgar Allan Poe. All right, that you have to study. Allan Poe. Edgar Allan Poe. All right, very important American writer. You know, Edgar Allan Poe is considered to be a writer of terror. People say terror. In Malayalam also, we have so many terrorist stories, like so many Neelakanda Paramara, a writer in Malayalam. Then Kottayam Pushpanath, all right, Malayalam writer, which would write the stories of what is called devils and yeshis, like Edgar Allan Poe is also considered to be a very terrorist writer. I mean, shows somewhat the stories of fantasy, what is called stories of devils and our unholy spirits like that. Even his biography shows that he had a lot of experience encountering hosts and devils in his life. And I don't know how many people of you have read Edgar Allan Poe's biography. In his biography, it is written, one of the days of a winter season, I have no time to narrate the whole incident, but I tell you how this writer, Edgar Allan Poe, who is writing so many stories of host and devils, what experience he had in his life. It is written in his biography, one day he was working in a factory, but even the factory has different shifts. That particular month or week, he had a night duty, and by the midnight he was coming to his house. He has no fear at all, because he neither believes in God and nor devils. Such an atheist character, Edgar Allan Poe. Once he was coming to his house, he had to pass through in front of a graveyard. All right, it is written in his biography. But it is something normal. The door was closed every day. He not in a position to notice. But that particular day, it was a very starry night. And unfortunately, he noticed the graveyard's gate was open in the midnight. It was a starry night. It is written in his biography. And he, out of apprehension, slowly moved to the graveyard. All of his sudden, a very big shadow appeared and clutched his hand and asked whether you have matches or whether you have cigarette lamp like. It is written in his biography. He showed the cigarette lamp. And the shadow took the cigarette lamp, opened. In the opening light, he saw a man who has a huge size with a big, ugly face which could not remember. And later it is written, all right, shadow showed something to a particular grave. He did not notice. Out of fear, he went to his house. But he was that time beginning a writer, and he was admitted in a hospital because of the high fever and fear. And what happened? So many journalists and doctors interviewed him. He told the incident, and the police people came to the graveyard and inspected all the premises. Then he saw the police people noticed a very big footmark and cigarette lamp, everything there. And this time, Edgar Allan Poe noticed, it is written in the book, he noticed the particular grave where written, normally we write rest in peace, R.I.P., with our date of birth and a date of death is equal to. Say particular date of day, particular year, particular time specified for the death of the person. Mean the person who is buried in the graveyard. Particular day, particular date of, the year, and it is written the particular time. Means Edgar Allan Poe noticed the man who died and buried in this cemetery on the day, time, then year is equal to Edgar Allan Poe's birthright. The day of birth, birth, and the year of birth is equal to the year of death. The time of death, the day of death of the person who has been buried there. What does he want to show? That the person who dies, his soul will take birth in different part of the world. Just like what we believe in Hindu philosophy, what is called rebirth concept. All right, rebirth after. So many philosophies are there that you have studied. No, it is part of the literature. What we know that the philosophy of Pythagoras, Pythagorean philosophy, what that transmigration of souls. All right, that is why sometime a particular person dies unfulfilling the wishes of life. All right, accidentally dies. His soul will enter to a particular animal which is fond of him. Probably I die unfulfilling my wishes. My soul will enter to my puppy or my cat. And this cat and puppy will begin to talk like me or behave like me. That is called transmigration of soul by the Pythagorean view of thought. So many thoughts and so many philosophies available. So Edgar Allan Poe says, one person's soul after death will go to different world and take birth in a particular day. So rebirth is possible. To show so many incidents in his biography, I narrated this incident which attracted me very much. So I would say all people should read biography of Edgar Allan Poe, and possibly you read, enjoy all the poems and stories written by Edgar Allan Poe. After 18th century, in the same way in England, America witnessed a romantic type of uplifting literature. So during the 19th century, all right, just like in Great Britain, who were the exponents of romantic revivals? Wordsworth was there, Shelley was there, John Keats was there, lot of poets who had been there to lift our ST, Coleridge was there. All these people were there to develop our romantic literature. One of the strong causes of romanticism was that they were against classicism. They do not find much grand style of writing poetry referring to so many epics and all that. Unfortunately, America has been a developing country during that time, controlled by migrants, and we don't find any epics like Iliad or Paradise Lost, like very epic writing like that. America cannot produce, so they have no writers previously, no pieces of writing previously to depend on. But Great Britain had lot of things to depend on. So there is inherent. So what is a very important writer called Thoreau? All right, that you have to keep. All right, Thoreau. All right, he brought transcendentalism. All right, transcendentalism. What is called transcendentalism? Inherent goodness in man and nature. Thoreau finds a goodness, a type of harmony between man and human nature. It is spoiled by the society and institution. Then in 19th century, romantic poets like Walt Whitman, a very, 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 very important poet, Walt Whitman. That you might have studied a poem, great poem in the small classes, what is called, "Oh, Captain, My Captain," that you have studied. All right, ferry me in your boat, like he calls a very big group of people to approach him, to show to the other world of the nature, and has been considered a very famous poem. That if you have not studied or read this poem, you people select from the Google or internet and read. His name is "Oh Captain, My Captain," a very important poem. Walt means then Emily Dickinson, romantic poets in America. Walt Whitman, Emily Dickinson. Autobiography, Walt means Leaves of Grass. All right, an autobiography written by Walt Whitman is Leaves of Grass. And Frank and popular poet, all these were people there. Emily Dickinson published a lot of books, published only after her death. Her technique of writing was adopted by so many people. So Walt Whitman, Edgar Allan Poe, Emily Dickinson, then novelists like Mark Twain. All right, you have studied Mark Twain, Tom Sawyer, or the Adventures of Tom Sawyer. Then that was in 1876, later part of 19th century. Life of Mississippi in 1883, Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, 1884. All these writers. So at least during the time of later part of the 18th century and the beginning part of the 19th century, these writers were very eminent and wrote so many books, so many poems, which developed American literature to its zenith of glory and now has been considered the best literature ever written in all the languages. Sometimes people say American literature surpasses British literatures in its quality and vision. And people say, normally what all the schools of thought that they have been depending on, called naturalism and some other major movements, that we will discuss in the next class. Till that moment, goodbye.